Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to create anchor or jump links in AEM. The anchor links are sometimes known as jump links, or a table of contents, or a bookmarks, or even in-page links. Anchor links are links that take you straight to another section of the page when clicked. The anchor links helps the users browsing your website to find the relevant information more quickly and easily. The anchor link consists of two parts. The first part is the anchor itself. You can associate a unique identifier to your page elements. Here if you see paragraph, then I am using anchor tag again, ID equal to test. This is the unique identifier. Then the content, test data. You can use any element and associate the unique ID. The second part consists of the actual link. If you see hashed link pointing to anchor element, so again anchor, href equal to hash test. Test is this unique ID. So whenever clicking on this link, the user will be taken to this content within the same page. Let us now see how to enable anchor links in AEM using RTE. I have installed the latest core components package version 2.15.2. As a first step, enable the design dialog configuration. So I'm going and here, edit template. So going with this text component, click on the policy. So if you see here plugins, so I am going with formatting. Select this option, show link insertion options, link, unlink and anchor. Even without selecting this option, link and unlink options are already displayed, but not this anchor. Looks to be an issue with the core component. Anyhow, select this so that other options, all options will be disabled. Additionally, the dialog and edit config node of the text proxy component should be modified to enable the anchor options. If you see, this is my proxy component, apps, my site, components, then text. So I overlaid this node from core text component inline and just modified this toolbar options. So if you double click this, so you can see the options. I added this links anchor. Earlier it was not there, only modify link and unlink was there. So click OK. Do the same thing for edit config. You can skip this configuration if the inline editing is not required, this specific anchor option. So if I go here in place editing, then again I overlaid this specific node inline. Then same thing here also, I enabled this option links anchor. So these two nodes are overlaid from here. If you go to core, the corresponding WCM components, then go to text. Yeah, then I did from V2, then text, then you can see CQ dialog has the same node. I overlaid that, then edit config also has the same node I overlaid. Only enabling the design dialog configuration should have displayed the option, the anchor option, but looks to be there is an issue with core component. And enabling only the design configuration is not working. So you should be doing this additional configuration. Let us now see the quick demo. I'm into this page. I'm going to the bottom of this page and adding a component text. Fine, I'm editing this. I'm going and adding a anchor element here. Add the content. So I will go with the test content for now. Select click here. Then select this. So I'm going to enter this test as the unique ID. So fine, now test content is there. Click OK. Now I'm adding another text component again here. So text. Okay, I'm moving this component maybe top of this page. Maybe I will go here. Yeah, that's fine. Now I'm going and enabling the hash link test. Select this and click on this. Okay, you can see here the options, target, same tab, like leave it to target. So then path, just to say hash, then the unique ID, test, whatever you enabled in the previous tab. Click on OK. Now you can see this as a link, this fine. Now maybe in the middle, I've added another component, maybe with a image. Fine, maybe I'll move here. Let me add an image. That's fine. I come down. This will be okay. Okay, fine now. Now let me view this as published. Now if you see here, there is a link. Also there is a content, test content. Now whenever you click on this test, see the browser is taking the user to the actual test content. So the content in the bottom of the page is linked from this link. So whenever somebody click on this test, they will be taken to this content. Let me inspect this test content, inspect. So here you can see there is a paragraph, then you can see anchor ID equal to test, then the content. Then if I go back to the link test and inspect it, yeah, the same thing, anchor href equal to has test. This is the unique ID of the anchor element over here, ID equal to test. The same configurations can be even enabled through inline editing mode. If I click here, this is the inline editing mode. You can see the same anchor option here, also link and unlink. Even you can unlink a link. If I click on this, select this, and you can say unlink. So the link will be removed. The anchor links are very useful to enable the links between the different sections of the web page. That's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.